with us, Mr. H.R. Khanform, a deputy governor of the RBI. Mr. Khan, thanks very much for joining us. You know, here is the Reserve Bank saying that we cautioned banks thrice in 2016. In fact, I had Mr. S.S. Mundra here on record on CNBC TV 18 in my interview say very clearly that in a speech that he made in 2016, he had cautioned about the misuse of SWIFT. Now, if that were the case, and clearly the Reserve Bank had enough reason to be sending out this confidential missive to public sector banks, why is it then that we're in this situation where something the size of 11,400 crore rupees, a fraud that has been perpetrated using the SWIFT system, has not come to light? So there seems to have been a failure on the part of the Reserve Bank, hasn't it?
No, I won't know what all has gone into after those advisories have been issued. And we had the issue of that Bangladesh case where there was a cyber fraud relating to SWIFT. We had a case of Union Bank where there was a SWIFT fraud. But here what was happening, some of the controls which were supposed to be in place were not probably in place. And when SWIFT was not integrated to CBS, there was all the more reasons to have very robust compensatory controls till such time it is integrated, and it should have been integrated in a time-bound manner. But it's a fact that many banks, when they moved to a new system, for example, Finacle 10, many banks did face the problems while switching over to the new system. So possibly that could have led to this delay in integration. But in the meantime, pending full-fledged integration, compensatory control should have been robust. I think probably RBI will look into what went wrong in terms of implementation of its advisory. Then only we'll come to know what was the
issue. So you're saying that the RBI needs to examine what went wrong. You know, we've finally heard from the finance minister. He has given his first reaction on the PNB issue, and he has held the PNB management. He's held also auditors and, of course, the supervisory agency, which in this case is the Reserve Bank, for what has gone wrong at Punjab National Bank in this Nirav Modi matter. The finance minister's argument, to put it simply, is, look, if you enjoy autonomy, then the responsibility lies at your door. How do you react to that, Mr. Khan?
No, there is always a gap in terms of mandate and the capacity to execute mandate. And fraudsters always go a few steps ahead of the controls and systems which are in place. Well, last year, even it has happened in major banks all over the world. The bank fraud is not something which is only unique to India or only unique to public sector bank. But the fact remains, yes, certain basic controls were probably not in put in place, maybe because they are migrating to a new system. But certainly it needs to be looked into, and I'm very happy that there is a committee under such a seasoned expert, Mr. Malega, has been set up to look into this. But I have slight confusion about this committee. This committee is looking at the divergences, which is a very important issue. At the same time, IT-related issues. So I'm slightly confused. But the whole idea of having Mr. Malega on the top of the committee is a great idea. He is an expert in that field, and he commands a lot of respect. I think that should be really...
So, Mr. Khan, given the fact that the RBI has now chosen to set up this committee headed by Mr. Malegaum to look at the issue of divergence, does that lead you to believe that we could perhaps be facing a serious problem when it comes to recognition that perhaps we are not fully out of the woods? Bankers keep telling us that the worst is behind us, and yet we see these divergence numbers. The fact that the Reserve Bank has now decided to set up this committee, does that seem to suggest that all is not right on the recognition front?
Well, there are multiple issues in terms of this. Again, we gave a total go-by to consortium lending. We had multiple banking. And in many accounts, there are 15, 20, 30, 40 banks lending to the same borrower. There is no proper exchange of information. So we had this acrylic system which came into place. Second is the whole old concept was, you recognize based on record of recovery in the individual bank. Whereas there may be cases that other bank has got other information and the project is not really completed, cash flows will not come, so you recognize as NPS, which information is not available to the bank. So auditors in some banks are handicapped in terms of not having full information about that particular borrower vis-a-vis all the lenders. So there is need for some dialogue between RBI and auditors and RBI and ICI. I think Mr. Malegaum will provide that valuable link to dialogue between the regulator and the auditors. because and also there are some gray areas in terms of rules and interpretation. I think that needs to be smoothened, and the whole issue of this how the IT system is being used in different banks. As you know, there is something called garbage in, garbage out, but the system is automated or there is some manipulation which happens so that you don't get the correct output and you are not in a position to generate the correct and accurate picture about the health of the accounts. So I think these are the issues which need to be looked into, and I'm sure Mr. Malegaon, given his expertise and other members, will contribute to finding a durable solution to this problem.
Thank you very much, Mr. Khan, for joining us. HR Khan, the former